Welcome friends, welcome to Kamath Astrology. Today we are going to talk about Ketu. So till now we have seen seven planets: Sun, Moon, Mars, Jupiter, Venus, Mercury and Saturn. So in this video I will be covering Rahu and Ketu in Vedic Astrology. Okay, now as we know, the Moon is a satellite of the Earth. That is, the Moon revolves around the Earth. Okay, so the Moon revolves around the Earth in an orbit, right? Similarly, the Earth revolves around the Sun in an orbit. So the point where the Moon's orbit around the Earth intersects the Earth's orbit around the Sun, okay, these points of intersection are the points of immense darkness. Okay, they are the points of immense energy. And in Vedic astrology, these are the points or the nodes which are known as Rahu and Ketu. Okay, so Rahu represents the ascending node or the north node, whereas Ketu represents the descending node or the south node. Also, as you know, all planets move in the anti-clockwise direction. Okay, however, Rahu and Ketu move in the clockwise direction. That is, they move in a direction opposite to all the other planets. Now, these planets are always 180 degrees apart. In fact, unlike other planets, these are not visible to the naked eye. Okay, so you cannot see these planets directly, and that is why they are just points of immense darkness, or they are also called as shadows in Vedic astrology. Okay, so they are called as chaya grahas, or they represent shadowy figures. All right, and whenever Rahu comes in contact with the Sun or the Moon, or even Ketu comes in contact with the Sun and the Moon, it results in a lunar eclipse or a solar eclipse. Okay, now these two mythical entities have immense importance in Vedic astrology. All right, each of these nodes, that is Rahu and Ketu, spends 1.5 years approximately in a sign. Okay, so to cover the entire zodiac with 12 signs, they take 18 years. All right. Now, what does Ketu represent in Vedic astrology? Okay. Now, when Ketu is placed in a sign, there are certain significations associated with that sign. Okay. For example, let us assume that Ketu is placed in the seventh sign in your horoscope, or the seventh house in your horoscope. Now, we know that the seventh house represents marriage, it represents spouse, it represents your partnerships, okay? It represents your daily income. So, now what happens when Ketu is placed in the seventh house? I'm talking about a general effect, okay? So, Ketu, when he's placed in a sign, it means that you have spent tremendous efforts in the significations related to that sign in your past life, okay? And so in this life, you have developed a disinterest towards those significations, okay? So now seventh house represents the marriage, and Ketu is placed in this sign, okay? So what happens is, you may be detached from your spouse. You may not be very much interested in your spouse, okay? Because in your previous life, you have already lived through a very nice married life, okay, and there were some unresolved conflicts. All right, so Ketu, thus placed in this sign of marriage, represents disinterest in married life. Okay, Ketu is also known as the Moksha Karaka when he is placed in the 12th house of the horoscope. Remember, the horoscope starts from the first house and ends from the 12th house. Okay, so the 12th house represents liberation or moksha, and thus Ketu gives liberation by creating disinterest, by creating hurdles in your path, Okay, so Ketu is actually a spiritual planet who has least interest in material things. Okay, now when I say material things, what do I mean? Material things can be money, can be your family affairs, can be your married life issues, okay, can be your children, all right, can be your house. So all these things are called as material things, all right, your material enjoyments. Okay, so Ketu has least interest in these things. Okay, so he is like a monk or a sadhu, okay, who will try to take you away from these things. So if he is placed in the seventh house, he will create disinterest in your married life. This is a very general interpretation of Ketu. Okay, so the main thing I wish to convey is wherever Ketu is placed, he generally tends to create a disinterest or hurdles in the significations related to that house. And the main intention behind this is to take you ahead on your spiritual path towards liberation. Okay, now in mythological lore, okay, there was a demon called Swarbhanu, okay, and while doing Amrit Manthan, all right, Lord Vishnu with his Sudarshan Chakra had cut the head of this demon, okay, and the head became Rahu and the body became Ketu. Now, before cutting the head of this demon, the demon had already drunk the Amrit, okay, so the Amrit went down his throat and the body became immortal. So Ketu is also a headless being, okay, so he has no head. The head is represented by a separate demon called Rahu, all right. So when you have a Ketu in your 10th house of horoscope and that Ketu is badly placed, okay, it means your mind will always be wandering. It will not be steady, okay. You will have very less interest in your career, and there will be lot of hurdles or obstacles created by Ketu in your career. Okay. Now, as I said, the head became Rahu and the body became Ketu. Now, because the Amrit had passed into the body became spiritually purified. Okay, whereas the head remained a material being. So this purified body is nothing but Ketu in Vedic astrology. Alright, now where does Ketu get exalted and where does he get debilitated? Various astrologers differ on this point, but the general agreement is that Ketu would get exalted in the sign of Jupiter in Sagittarius or Dhanu Rashi. Why? Because Ketu is a spiritual being just like Jupiter. Okay, and so he tends to give very good results in this house of Sagittarius or Dhanu. Alright, and he gets debilitated in the sign of Gemini or Mithun, which belongs to Mercury. Ketu is also considered as the co-ruler of the sign Scorpio or Vrishik Rashi along with Mars. Okay, that is, Mars is the main owner of Vrishik Rashi, but Ketu is also considered as a co-ruler of this sign. Alright, why? Because the 8th house, that is Vrishik Rashi in the natural zodiac, represents the 8th house, and the 8th house represents accidents, it represents hurdles, okay, it represents inheritance, it represents buried things. Alright, now what are the remedies for a malefic Ketu in your horoscope? Now whenever Ketu is malefic, say he is placed in the 10th house, okay, the first thing he will try to do is take you away from your work or from your job. So what he will do is he will disturb the relations with your boss, okay, there will be frequent conflicts with your boss. Alright, he will create disinterest in your mind for the work which you are doing. Okay, so Ketu is now giving obstacles. Alright, now in mythology, the son of Shiva and Parvati, that is Lord Ganesha, okay, his head was also cut by Lord Shiva, okay, and so he was also a headless being whose head was then replaced by the head of an elephant, and he was known as Ganesha. Okay, So Ganesha has been given the power to remove all the obstacles. Alright, so he is the overlord of Ketu. That is, he is the controlling deity of Ketu. So if in a horoscope Ketu is giving problems, worshipping Lord Ganesha is said to alleviate or reduce the malefic effects of Ketu. Alright, so this is the first remedy. Whenever Ketu is badly placed, you should start worshipping Lord Ganesha. Alright, what is the other remedy? Ketu is said to reside in dogs. Okay, so if you serve dogs on Saturday with good food, okay, with rotis, with bones, then Ketu is said to be pleased. Okay, because dogs are always wandering around, okay, aimlessly. So Ketu represents this aimless wander which is seen in dogs. Okay, now when does Ketu become a malefic in your horoscope? So when does Ketu become a malefic in your horoscope? Now in your previous lives, if you have harmed dogs or snakes, okay, or if you have aborted an unborn child, okay, which was created by your mistake, in that case Ketu becomes malefic in your horoscope. Alright, so the remedies to remove the bad effects of Ketu I have already explained. Okay, now let us move to the next node, that is Rahu. Now as I said, Ketu tries to take you away from things, okay, but Rahu is the exact opposite. Okay, Rahu is very cunning, he is extremely intelligent, he is sharp-witted. Okay, so what he does is he tries to bring material things to you. Okay, but once you start enjoying those material things, slowly you will realize the bad effects of those things. For example, let us say Rahu is placed in the fifth house of a horoscope. Okay, now what does the fifth house represent in Vedic astrology? It represents children, it represents education, it represents wisdom, okay, it represents love. So when Ketu is placed in the fifth house of the horoscope, alright, fifth house represents children. So there may be a couple who want a son, okay, but they don't want a daughter. Alright, so there are often such couples you come across who are very insisting that they have a son. Okay, so because a son carries the family lineage ahead, that is their belief, okay, which I don't agree to completely. Alright. So now what Rahu will do? Rahu will give this couple a male child, okay, just like what they desired. But as the child grows up, the child becomes very naughty, okay. He does not listen to anyone, he cannot be controlled by his parents. His parents give him a lot of pocket money, they give him a lot of love because fifth house also represents love, okay. But a time comes when this son throws his parents out of their house, okay, he does not like his parents, and so the overall effect, that is, Rahu gave you what you wanted, but in the end you realize that what he gave you was not really what you had anticipated. Okay, so Rahu represents obsession, he represents compulsive desires, he represents deception, he represents illusion, he represents smoke. Okay, so Rahu is a shadow actually, and what happens is a shadow is created whenever light falls on an object, right? So whenever Rahu comes in close conjunction with the moon, what happens is the sun, the earth and the moon are in a straight line, okay? The sun's light falls on the earth, okay? And the shadow falls on the moon. Okay, so Rahu obstructs the light, that is, Rahu obstructs the noise of the soul, the sound of your soul, the sound of your consciousness, okay, and you get drawn into material things which may not really benefit you. Okay, so Rahu can give you the ability to work very hard, okay, and to get what you want, but in the end you realize that this is not really what you want. For example, suppose Rahu is placed in the second house of the horoscope, okay, Second house gives you wealth, right? So Rahu will give you immense wealth. But it will also give you a tendency to spend this wealth on wrong things. So you may get into drugs, addiction, alcohol, which in the long run will prove harmful to you, right? Now, why Rahu does this is he wants to teach you that all these material things which you are aspiring for are in reality not good for you, okay? So that is what he wants to teach you basically. And that is why he gives you what you want. But in the end, the results are not what you expected like. Alright. Now, like Ketu, Rahu spends 1.5 years in one sign. Okay. So to transverse the entire zodiac, it will take 18 years. Alright. Whenever Rahu comes in conjunction with any planet, say Mars. Okay. It will amplify the effects of that planet. What do I mean now by this? Mars represents aggression, right? Mars represents a soldier. Mars represents a fighter. So when Mars comes in conjunction with Rahu, Rahu will amplify the fighting ability or aggression of Mars manifold. Okay, that is many times. All right. So this is also called as Angarak Yoga in astrology. All right. When Rahu comes in contact with Jupiter, Jupiter is a pure spiritual being, okay? And Rahu represents obsession, he represents desires, he represents status, okay? So such a teacher will get influenced by the characteristics of Rahu, okay? And he will run behind power, status, okay? Name and fame, which in the end may prove harmful to him. Okay, now where does Rahu get exalted? Rahu gets exalted in the sign of Gemini or Mithun Rashi, okay, and he gets debilitated in the sign of Sagittarius. Sagittarius is the sign where Ketu was getting exalted. Now, why does Rahu get debilitated here? See, Sagittarius represents spiritual things, okay, it's the ninth house of the horoscope in the natural zodiac, which represents Dharma, okay, so Rahu obviously falls here because Rahu does not adhere to Dharma. He represents foreigners, he represents outcasts, okay, he represents thieves, he represents deceptive people, all right. So in the sign of Sagittarius, Rahu falls, but in the sign of Mithun or Gemini, Rahu gets exalted. Why is this so? Because Gemini is the third house of the natural horoscope. Okay, third house represents communication, it represents efforts, it represents your marketing skills. Okay, so when a sharp and intelligent being like Rahu comes in the third house, okay, you would be very witty in your communication. All right, and people in marketing are especially benefited by the Rahu here. So Rahu gets exalted in the sign of Gemini. And Mercury is also considered as a friend of Rahu. Okay, so Mercury also represents your speech, it represents your intellect, it represents wisdom. Okay, now what are the remedies for Rahu if he is badly placed in your horoscope? So the controlling deity of Rahu is Goddess Durga. Okay, so if you worship Goddess Durga on Saturdays and Wednesdays, it will reduce the malefic effects of Rahu. Okay, reciting the Durga Saptashati chapters is especially beneficial if you are afflicted by a malefic Rahu. All right. The other remedy for Rahu is to serve people of people who work below you. Rather, I would say sweepers, leprosy patients, etc. Okay, so if you donate food to these people on Saturdays, Rahu is said to be pleased. All right. What other remedy is there for Rahu? All right. If you worship Brihaspati or Guru, Rahu's effects are said to be reduced because Brihaspati represents the good things. He represents auspiciousness. All right. Rahu is also pleased if you worship Lord Shiva on a Monday, okay? Because Shiva and Parvati are both presiding deities of Rahu. Rahu is a great devotee of Shiva. All right? Now, we'll come to the gemstones of Rahu and Ketu. Okay. The gemstone of Rahu is known as Hesonite, or it is also known as Gomed. And the gemstone of Ketu is known as Lasunia, or also Cat's Eye. Okay. Now, it should be worn in the middle finger of your right hand, depending on Rahu and Ketu's position in your horoscope. Okay, do this only after consulting a good astrologer. Alright, because the effects of Rahu and Ketu are very uncertain, they are sudden effects. Okay, so it's advisable to consult a good astrologer. If Rahu or Ketu is extremely badly placed in your horoscope, you can donate these gemstones to a poor person on Saturdays. Okay, so this was what I wanted to cover about Rahu and Ketu. So thank you all, and I hope to see you soon. If you like this video, do mark it as liked. Okay. If you want professional consulting, you can download my application Kamath Astrology from Google Play Store, or you can visit our website astroseva.tripod.com. Okay. If you would like more videos from me, please feel free to subscribe to this channel. So whenever I add a new video, you will automatically get intimated. So thank you, folks. Hope to see you soon. Have a nice day. Before I conclude, just one more thing to add. We forgot to speak about the Mahadasha of Rahu and Ketu. So Rahu's Mahadasha is for 18 years. Okay. And Ketu's Mahadasha is for 7 years. So, for 18 years of your life, Rahu controls the major portion, okay, in his Mahadasha. And Ketu's Mahadasha is 7 years. So, during those 7 years, Ketu greatly influences your life, okay. So, this was one thing I wish to add. So, guys, thank you. Thanks a lot. Hope to see you soon.